Unfortunately, today in any country, it's hard to find clean water, but alcohol is easy to get. Science shows that people who drink often feel calm. Their worries fade for a while, but over time, they need more alcohol to feel the same peace. Many families with a bright future lost everything because of alcohol. When the main earner becomes addicted, it brings mental and financial stress. Time and money are wasted on drinking. Some of you may think, "I only drink sometimes, I'm not an addict." But after watching this video, you may be shocked. How harmful is alcohol? What is the safe limit? Why does it intoxicate? And what's the difference between beer, vodka, whiskey, and rum? In reality, alcohol forms naturally. When fruits get too ripe, their sugar increases. This sugar attracts yeast, a tiny fungus. The yeast eats the sugar and causes a reaction. It releases carbon dioxide into the air, and alcohol stays inside the fruit. This process is called fermentation. When grains like wheat or barley are soaked in water and exposed to air, yeast reacts with them. Fermentation begins, and beer is made. The first beer wasn't intentional. It happened by accident. Similarly, when grapes ferment, the alcohol is called wine. This process can happen naturally. Beer comes from fermented wheat, wine from grapes, rice wine from rice, cider from apples, and banana beer from bananas, popular in Africa. Chicha is made from fermented corn in South America. Toddy comes from fermented coconut sap. Even wheat dough can ferment. That gives us sourdough bread with better flavor and air bubbles. This bread has only a tiny trace of alcohol. The main byproduct is lactic acid. Fermenting fruits can make both ethanol and methanol. Methanol is deadly. A certain amount can kill you. Even less can make you go blind. So never eat rotten, fermented fruits. Just because it's natural doesn't mean it's safe. Apple cider and beer have 4 to 8% alcohol. Wine has 9 to 15%. Rice wine has 12 to 16% alcohol. When alcohol goes above 18 to 19%, it becomes toxic for yeast and fermentation stops. So someone found a way to increase alcohol by boiling it. Alcohol evaporates faster than water. If you collect and cool the vapors, the liquid you get has more alcohol. This is called distillation. Alcohol from distillation can be 30% to 60%. Beer is distilled to make whiskey. Wine becomes brandy. Tequila comes from distilling the blue agave plant. Rum is made by fermenting and distilling sugarcane. Vodka is made from distilled potatoes. But interestingly, fermented potatoes alone aren't safe to drink. Over time, people mixed alcohol with soda and juice, and that's how cocktails were made. But no matter the type of drink, one thing stays the same: ethanol. That's the chemical we call alcohol. So how does it affect your body? Only 20% of alcohol is absorbed in the stomach. The rest is digested in the small intestine, where it enters the blood. Between the stomach and small intestine is a muscle called the pyloric sphincter. It controls how fast food moves from the stomach to the intestine. When your stomach is full, this muscle stays closed. So alcohol stays in the stomach longer and enters the blood slowly. But on an empty stomach, the muscle opens. Alcohol reaches the intestine fast and mixes with your blood quickly. That's why drinking on an empty stomach causes faster intoxication. Whiskey with soda or champagne has carbon dioxide. It puts pressure on the stomach and pushes alcohol quickly to the small intestine and then into the blood. The alcohol then spreads all over the body, especially to areas with high blood flow, like the liver and brain. The liver is a key organ. It filters out toxins. It uses an enzyme called ADH, which turns alcohol into acetaldehyde. Acetaldehyde is poisonous and causes headaches. Then another enzyme, ALDH, turns acetaldehyde into acetate, which is safe. Acetate later breaks down into water and carbon dioxide. Hangovers stop when the liver removes this poison. But the liver can only work at a fixed speed. If you drink slowly, it can keep up. But most people drink fast and feel more drunk. Then alcohol builds up in the blood, raising your blood alcohol concentration. Police use this to check drunk drivers. When you blow into the machine, it reads the alcohol level in your breath. Alcohol affects the brain the most. The brain is made of many neurons, which use neurotransmitters to talk to each other. Alcohol mainly affects two of them, GABA and glutamate. GABA slows things down and calms us. Glutamate keeps the brain active. Alcohol increases GABA and reduces glutamate. This stops neurons from connecting properly and slows down brain activity. That's why people feel relaxed or sleepy after drinking. But drinking too much can slow the brain so much that it may stop vital functions like breathing, and that can be fatal. Alcohol also triggers dopamine, the feel-good chemical. and it releases endorphins, the body's natural painkillers and mood boosters. This is why people feel happy and comfortable after drinking. As the liver starts removing alcohol from the blood and the brain absorbs less, the person slowly sobers up. Alcohol stays up to 12 hours in the blood, 12 hours in saliva, 12 to 24 hours in breath and urine, and up to 90 days in hair, especially after heavy drinking. In the long term, drinking alcohol regularly can shrink your brain. It literally becomes smaller. Neurons shrink or die. The frontal lobe, which controls decision-making, focus, and emotions, is damaged the most. That's why long-term alcoholics often lose control over their emotions and get angry easily. The hippocampus, the part of the brain linked to memory and reasoning, also gets smaller. The more you drink, the higher the risk of blackouts, not remembering what happened while drunk. This is because alcohol blocks short-term memories from turning into long-term ones. You start forgetting things. Beyond the brain, the liver also suffers. It works overtime to clean your blood and gets damaged in the process. There are four stages of liver damage. First is fatty liver. Fat builds up in the liver. This stage can be reversed if you stop drinking. If you keep drinking, the second stage is hepatitis. The liver becomes swollen and painful. Then comes fibrosis. Scar tissue starts forming. The final stage is cirrhosis. The liver becomes stiff and stops working. This stage is irreversible and can lead to liver failure. Even the early stages may require hospitalization, and medical treatment can be expensive. Many families lose their savings or fall into debt. They take loans just to pay the hospital bills. Drinking alcohol weakens the heart muscles. It can make your heartbeat irregular and cause high blood pressure over time. This increases the risk of heart disease, heart attacks, and strokes. Alcohol also harms the pancreas, the organ that makes enzymes to digest food. Due to alcohol, these enzymes become active too early and start digesting the pancreas itself. This can be very painful and dangerous. It can also damage your kidneys, increase bile production in the liver, and lead to diarrhea. Long-term alcohol abuse may cause painful ulcers and even internal bleeding. Now, if you're an occasional drinker, you might think you're safe. But even drinking once weakens your immune system for the next 24 hours. With regular occasional drinking, this effect becomes permanent. That's why heavy drinkers often get sick more easily, with flu, colds, and infections. There's a common myth that one glass of alcohol isn't harmful. But the World Health Organization says no amount of alcohol is safe. Even a little can increase your risk. So next time someone says, "One peg won't hurt," share this video with them. There's another popular myth that red wine is good for your health. People often point to the French, saying they drink wine and still stay healthy. They claim red wine has antioxidants. Yes, it's true, red wine has antioxidants. But those antioxidants come from grapes. If you eat grapes, you'll get even more of them without alcohol's harmful effects. The ethanol in red wine still harms your body. Its negative effects are much stronger than the small benefit of antioxidants. A 2025 study found no difference in cancer risk between red and white wine. So, the truth is, no type of wine is safe to drink. Another myth is about hard liquor. Some people say beer or wine is safer because they are natural or soft drinks. But your liver doesn't care what type of alcohol you drink. The only difference is the concentration. So, people drink different amounts. One pint of strong beer, one glass of wine, and one shot of whiskey all have about the same amount of alcohol, roughly 10 to 14 grams of ethanol. When all other excuses fail, some people say alcohol keeps them warm in cold weather. But that's just another myth. Yes, alcohol makes you feel warm at first, but it doesn't actually produce heat. It expands blood vessels near the skin, making you feel hot. But this causes your body to lose heat faster. Your core body temperature drops. In cold weather, this can lead to hypothermia. So while you feel warm, your body becomes more at risk from the cold. And when all logic ends, some people say, "It's my life. I'll do what I want." But this isn't a valid reason. Because alcohol doesn't just harm your health. It also harms the people around you. Alcohol increases the risk of domestic violence. Drunk driving also causes the death of innocent people. Children who grow up in homes where alcohol is consumed suffer deeply. They face higher risks of anxiety, depression, and even future addiction. They may be beaten or forced to watch their parents fight. But the most dangerous thing about alcohol is its addictive nature. Alcohol hijacks the brain's reward system. It releases dopamine and endorphins, making the brain believe alcohol is the easiest way to feel happy or relaxed. Soon, people start depending on alcohol for confidence, joy, or to escape pain. We hear this all the time. Let's celebrate with a drink. Let's forget our pain with a drink. Let's calm down with a drink. This is how addiction starts. Over time, tolerance builds. That doesn't mean your body is healthier. It means you need more alcohol to feel the same effect. Someone who used to feel good after two beers now needs four, just to feel the same. Eventually, they need alcohol just to function normally. This is called alcohol dependence syndrome. They say things like, I can't think straight. I need a drink. And if they try to quit, their body reacts. Hands shake. Cravings hit hard. They feel sick without it. The brain has become so used to alcohol, it can't function properly without it. They shiver, sweat, feel anxious, and can't sleep. Some even hallucinate or have seizures. At this stage, many have no option but to drink again just to feel normal. This is a dangerous trap, and it's why so many alcoholics eventually die from drinking too much. According to WHO data, alcohol causes 2.6 million deaths every year. That's about 4.7% of all global deaths. Alcoholics are also more likely to commit suicide. A review of 16 studies found that around 40% of people who take their own life had consumed alcohol. In some studies, the number was as high as 73%. This problem is worse among the poor, because poverty and alcohol create a vicious cycle. One problem makes the other worse. People who are already struggling with stress, unemployment, and sadness often turn to alcohol as a quick escape. But this escape only pulls them deeper into poverty. The most painful part is that the cheapest alcohol available to the poor is often the most dangerous. Unrefined or illegal alcohol may contain toxic methanol or industrial spirits. You've likely heard stories of people dying after drinking such alcohol. If you or someone close to you is struggling with alcohol, recognize the problem and seek help. Many people never admit it, and things only get worse. Admitting there is a problem is the first step. The second step is not being ashamed to ask for help. There are many resources available. You can call your government's toll-free helpline for confidential support, or reach out to groups like Alcoholics Anonymous. They host free, anonymous meetings. Visit their website to find a support group near you. You'll meet people who've beaten addiction and now support others. Professional help is also an option through rehabilitation centers, counseling, or detox medication. We must also address this issue on a social level. If you're watching this video, make a promise, never drink alcohol. And if a friend pressures you to drink, share this video with them. Let them see how their small suggestion could ruin someone's life. You don't need alcohol to enjoy a party. Next time, pick water over an alcoholic drink. H2O is safer, tastier, and much better for your health than C2H5OH. We must challenge the idea that one drink won't hurt, because for thousands, maybe millions, it was that one drink that started their downfall. Governments also need to step up. Instead of just making money from alcohol taxes, they must take real action. They should control surrogate ads, ads that pretend to sell something safe while promoting alcohol. Thank you very much.